106 KMEL.
Broadcasting live from the BET Awards, your girl Shay Diddy, 106 KMEL, and the one and only Dietrich Haddon. How are you?
What's good, Shay? It's a wonderful thing to see you.
Oh,
looking
my
beautiful.
All the way from
Detroit.
Did
y'all know she's beautiful?
Oh.
And it's good to see you.
Coming from a gospel singer and preacher.
Come on now.
You know, that is truly a blessing.
That's a blessing.
I know. So how does it feel to be nominated this year?
It's a wonderful thing. I was nominated 3 times before, so this is my 4th time. I lost 3 times in a row.
So now it's your time.
Yeah, and I'm a sore loser. It better be my time this time.
Are you really a sore loser? Are you the one who's like?
I can't. My family would tell you. We don't want to play no games with Dietrich because he will flip the table over if he can't win.
He probably sat back in his chair and was like,
Right.
Yeah. No, I understand.
Sometimes
I'll
be like, please don't nominate me, especially if y'all are not going to give it to me. But it says that people are recognizing the hard work that you're putting in, so I appreciate that.
Yeah, no, definitely. Yeah. So is there any new music that we can look forward to?
Absolutely. Got a brand new record called Masterpieces dropping in October. New music coming next week.
Mm-hmm.
New TV shows, new everything.
Really?
Yeah.
So
what
made you want to do The Preachers TV show?
Oh, that was my idea.
That was all you?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
And I'm one of the executive producers. It's a team of us. Lemmy Plummer and Holly Carter. That's three.
Right.
And a few other people. But I was going through a tough time in my life, and I just thought that people need to know the truth about what we as preachers and men of God and gospel singers go through.
Yeah.
A lot of times they think we're just, we don't go through tests and trials or we don't make mistakes. So I thought it was important for me to show people how to get back up after you've messed up.
You know?
So that was my agenda for season 1, and it worked well for us. Millions tuned in, and we did a season 2, and millions tuned in, and now they're franchising to Atlanta.
Oh, wow.
We're in Atlanta shooting right now, and then we did Detroit, mm-hmm. and Preachers of LA is coming back in August.
Oh, mm-hmm. We definitely have a lot to look forward to. Now, you know, we had a huge ruling yesterday where they legalized gay marriage across the country. How do you feel about that?
That's a tough one,
mm-hmm.
because if you are a Christian and you go by what the Bible says, it's not for that.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm a Christian. I go by what the Bible says. But
right.
I do believe that everybody have the freedom to make their own choices.
Yeah.
God has given us the freedom to make our own choices.
Yeah.
And you live by the choices that you make. So I'm not one of those preachers that would judge you because you made the choice to marry somebody. That's you.
Yeah.
You live your life. Because at the end of the day, none of us know until you go on judgment day and you go before God. And he'll say who's who can come in, who can't, who can't. That's what I think where people get hung up, Christians get hung up at.
Yeah.
You trying to judge people before judgment day.
Exactly.
And you can't
That's not your job. That's not your job.
You can't do that.
Yeah.
I know it says in the word that you ain't supposed to do this and do that. But give people the freedom to live their lives. Give people the freedom to do what they do in their lives. And in the end, you know, I'm trying to make it in myself, so I can't. I'm trying to keep things going myself, so I ain't got time to judge nobody.
So basically, if somebody needed to come to you and needed some guidance, you wouldn't turn your back because of their personal.
No way. I've seen it all as a preacher, young preacher, pastor, and I've seen it all. I've counseled all types of situations.
Yeah.
And one thing you will not get me to do is to judge anybody. I would tell people.
Okay.
My duty is to show you what's in the Bible.
Yeah.
You make the choice from there. You're grown.
He said you're grown.
You go from there, and you're grown. And in whatever decision you make, I'm not going to look down on you. I'm not going to think. I'm not going to say I'm better than you, because even people with the cloth, men of the cloth, people that wear suits and ties, missionaries wrapped in swaddling clothes, they have their issues too.
Yeah, definitely.
So you can't judge anybody.
Do you feel like you've been judged since doing the show?
Oh, absolutely. They done ran me through the streets. They took me and drug me all up through the street.
How do you handle that, though? Because that can be a lot of pressure and can
take
an emotional toll.
No pressure for me. I'm from Detroit.
Oh.
We go through it. We had to fight on the way to school and back from school. It's what it is, you know?
Yeah.
So I was, and I was the minister of music of my church when I was 13 years old.
Oh, wow.
So I was responsible for like 100 voices of young adults and teenagers.
Yeah.
So I learned tough skin at an early age. I got tough skin.
You got thick skin.
So nobody bothers, none of that bothers me. What people have to say about me, the show, what I said on the show,
yeah.
I really don't care.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, I'm going to do me.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
You put it out there for y'all to enjoy.
Enjoy.
You enjoy it.
Exactly. And you're tuning in.
Exactly.
You know? They're tuning in to run me down, but it's cool.
The
ratings are well, and I'm getting more TV shows as a result of it.
Because whether you want it or not, you're still getting paid.
Right. Come on now. Come on now. Come on, somebody.
So are we going to get a new album from you soon? Or
absolutely. And this new record is crazy. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, I'm opening up the studio Tuesday for all my fans to come hang out with me at the studio on Tuesday.
Oh, wow.
Just doing a listening session. Going to play them like 6 songs from the new record.
Okay.
And let them say which songs they like. They want to hear it on radio.
So if we were trying to get in there as a fan, how can they get in that?
Well, you got an RSVP. It's already loaded now.
Oh.
I put it up the day of. And yeah. It's limited space. We only can hold like 100 people.
Okay.
So I'll be hanging out at the studio just chopping it up, you know, let them see what I do and listen to the music. It's going to be fun. Getting over this little cold, but new record is going to be crazy. It's really not your typical gospel record. The beats are crazy. Beats are hard. It's like anything you hear on the radio, but it has the inspirational message in it.
You know?
That's the difference.
Well, I was going to ask you, would you think about collaborating with other Detroit artists like Dej Loaf?
I love Dej Loaf. I love her.
Really?
Yes. And I got all the records. I ride to them and listen to them.
Really?
See, I know how to eat the fish, spit out the bones.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying?
A lot of people don't know how to do that. Yeah, they don't understand that concept.
I'm grown. I'm mature, so I know how to. I know what's what won't. Yeah, you're grown. I know what don't work for me. I know what works for me. So, but I love Dej Loaf. I love her flow, her style.
Mm-hmm.
That Try Me record was crazy.
Yeah.
Her flow was crazy on that. So, Big Sean, shout out to anybody that's doing it big from Detroit.
Yeah.
Because it's a bad, Detroit has a bad little reputation. You know what I'm saying? But when you see people doing it, like Eminem and Dej Loaf and Kid Rock is doing it, you know, I'm proud. Like it's on my own brothers and sisters.
Well, one thing I did want to say to you is you might be one of the most well-dressed creatures I've ever met.
What?
Look at your gear that you have on, though. That hat is
really
killing it alone.
Oh, thank you.
Look at the jacket with the kind of floral Sahari print pants. I'm like, okay, I see you.
I'm
that's
all
very California-ish. You know what I mean?
LA all the way. No, I'm into style. I believe that you got to do you. You got to have your flavor with it. So it's important to me.
Well, thank you so much for checking in with us. It was very inspirational. And
thank you so much. Anytime. Y'all show me some love, San Fran.
Hoping that you walk away tomorrow night with your first BET award.
Yes, say a prayer for me.
I definitely will.
Please. Talk to the Lord about it. Maybe you give it to me.
Oh, yeah. Backstage Live BET Awards 2015. Your girl Shay Diddy and Dietrich Haddon.
Awesome. Thank you.